Hello and welcome to day 45 in creating this PHP Web Framework series, and we are going to continue with notifications. It is part two. In the last video, we just briefly created this notifications class. We created the table for notifications. It's a basic table that's extendable beyond what we have at the moment for your needs. And we had notification types in there. We just have two, like and response. Again, you can just extend it, add more as you need to. So the method, the first thing we're gonna look at implementing is a create notification method. So in here, we're gonna have a method called public. For create, I guess you could call it insert. I don't like the thing insert. It's not like inserting into a notification, are you? So I know you're inserting it into the database. We'll have a look at what I used for email. This is called send for forum, for example. There will be something about creating insert question. Yeah, I'm saying create. And this will take, let's have a look what it's going to take. So ID is automatically generated. The type, it requires a type. So dollar type, which by default will equal null. Dollar user ID, actually I need to do a bit of research. I'm not too sure what would be the purpose. This is just some basic PHP knowledge I need to fix up on, of by default setting value here. It'd be useful if, for example, you could call this method and let's say you're passing in a number. So by default you set to zero, or otherwise you're passing in a number and then you do something with it. But we're not going to do something if it's null. So PHP purpose of default function just need to see what the purpose of it is. Didn't really find much regarding that. I think it might not be like recommended or required. Obviously it's not required, but you know what I mean. Not needed really. It's optional. Don't pass any argument when declare a function like below. Yeah, I think it's only useful if you was going to do something with it otherwise. So if we Just want to have a look at the forum because I want to just in general take inspiration from it. So, okay. Type user ID title. So, dollar title now, notifications. Dollar title. Dollar timestamp. No, that's automatically generated. And that by default is set to null anyway. So, I mean, zero, false. So, first of all, what I want to. Let's kick something under my desk that I really shouldn't have. Okay, so from forum, what we want to do is do something similar to this where we've got user. And if I put that into notifications here, and in the user class, there will be a method. We want to see if it's a valid user, basically. So I want to call the find method. So realistically it needs to return true or false. So find dollar user, so if it's an ID or yeah, fine. So and this way it, we could potentially not have it based on user ID, it could be based on one of the other unique fields like username or email. Probably won't do it like that, but it provides that extension if we want to. So if dollar user find, so if this is true, dollar user ID else we're gonna do an error thing. So forums, have a look at the error system on here. The error that we're going to put is very simple. It's just unable to post comment at this time, please try again later. Then we're going to say unable to insert notification at this probably won't get printed out, but it's just we're going to add it there, and you know the time may come when you, let's say, set up some sort of testing features or something that keeps tracks and logs stuff, especially when stuff is happening well, and you can just use the built-in error system. So if it's found the user, great. That means, I'm gonna put a comment here, create/insert the notification into the database. So if it's found the user, fantastic. We can actually just do the insertion now. So again, how do we do this? Let's copy and paste this. So notifications, whack that here, sort out the indentation and type, dollar type. Next we have is dollar user ID, and this is going to be dollar user ID. This is a good idea. If we get it from the user object and we use the ID, because obviously the user object has the actual user because we've done the find method. If this is, actually, is that the same thing that we did in forum? Do we use for find? Just if the user's logged in. Okay. Okay. So yeah, because if he finds it, we by definition it'll store it, and it can only get to here if it finds it. So it should be there. And this way, if let's say we do pass in an email address or username, we don't have to make sure that the user ID column can accommodate that because they just an integer. So that's the good thing about doing it this way. Title. And this is gonna be dollar title. Next we have is timestamp. Oh, somebody's at the door. Just hold on a second. And I'm back. But yeah, just sorry about that. That was just my parents. They were just dropping off a few things. Again, sorry about that, I'm back. So yeah, just have my parents quickly just drop a few things off. I usually have stuff delivered to their house as there's always somebody in there and I might be out. One thing they dropped off was just my Cineworld Unlimited card. I already had that. I basically just lent it to my brother to have a go. I think you can guess what I mean. And the other thing that I got was Splatoon 2, so just a day early. By the time this video is uploaded, it will actually be Friday, but I'm creating it on Thursday, as you can see right here. And my mom and dad had just been somewhere and there was some muffins there, so they just bought me some back as well. So I'll have a butcher's at these, see what they're like. Okay, bring my friend on. Let's continue with this. Title, timestamp. Stamp. And that's it. And the other things have default values anyway. And this is going to be, we need the notification table name. Drop something on the floor. Turn true. Unable to find user. Unable to find user. Please check. The ID is valid. Unable to insert notification. So, in create a new, we'll just call it doing testing. So, new file notifications.php. Actually, probably doesn't really warrant a new file. Probably can just do it within. Do within the miscellaneous one. So dollar notifications equals. Oh, I forgot to set it up. So miscellaneous dollar notifications. New notifications, make sure audio's on. Yes, it is. New notifications, and we need to pass in two tables. Again, I've just forgot how to do that. Will be what am I looking for? This is it. So in notification, I mean in miscellaneous, we'll need to put this. And I believe we have, we have a config for notifications. And these are the names of the stuff. So copy that, go into here, go into here, put in notifications. Copy that, work that into here. Okay, and now this one as well. But we're not using it yet. Still needs it to be construct it. And now we can just do dollar notifications. Echo, we'll echo out if we get a valid response or not. Okay, I'll do this statement. So if dollar notifications, I'll finish that sentence off in a second. Echo, yay, else, echo, nay. So, if I do create, if I go back to notifications, copy this so I know exactly what needs to be inserted. And we're gonna do dollar type will be pretty as like, for example, like. User ID will be eight and title will be hello, this is awesome. Now let's have a look at that page. It is in testing miscellaneous. There's no PHP tags. Miscellaneous line 3 equals new sonar notifications. Class config not found. I'm guessing I need to do it like this. Because I'm not using namespace. Okay, nay. Therefore, if we go to notification, we should have zero notification in there. Something went wrong. So now I need to figure out what went wrong and we'll fix it. So if we go to notifications, could print out the errors, but I'll just do it manually. So something's gone wrong, and I'm gonna do the echo one exit. Like the error system is great as well, but for testing, I like to do it this way, especially just quick testing. Now refresh. No, that's not it. Go refresh the other page, and so it's saying unable to insert notification. Notification table name fields. I think I figured it out. 1, 2, 3, 4. Got a time edited as well. We shouldn't be there. We go back to it. Yay, browse, boom. Okay, that was a quick fix. That was nice and easy. Now that's in there. What would happen if I were to go to miscellaneous and put in 88? That is not a valid user ID, because if I show you here, we have 8, 9, and 10. So refresh, nay. That is, ooh, no, no, no. So that is all good. And what other things can we try and check out? Guess all of that would be fine. Another thing I want to have a look at is in forum when we. Yeah, it's probably best if we do something like a base64 encode. Where's title used? Oh, there it is. That's like user inserted data, where you know this one isn't. Okay, so yeah, I need the base64 encode. So in notifications, because one of the reasons for that is we'll like for Sonar Learning, though that is just an ID, you might put something in there that's based on user input. And thus, you know, you've got input from the user, and that's what is going to be left in notification title, description, or you know, anything like that. There's no harm in encoding it. The only harm comes when you think there is no harm in not encoding it, and then the harm comes. Okay, so I was on here. I need to encode title. So based on that, I need to have a look at the length of form questions in nice text. Is that big? It needs to be text. Text. So edit that, change text, get rid of the length, and now if I were to redo this, still getting an error. I'm probably getting it because I haven't in here changed back to, so if I were to change this to a 10 for example. We get an encrypted value now, and the timestamp as well, that is increasing, which is good. And I'm actually gonna wrap it up soon, because again, I want to keep the video short, but it makes it more manageable for me. I'm going to pump it out on a regular basis. So yeah, in terms of progression, this is actually progressing it faster. So create notification method, that's done. Next one is just gonna be by retrieving it. And then we'll look at, you know, getting all notifications for a set user. So like getting all notifications are probably more like an admin thing if the need arises, whereas otherwise you would be doing it for a set user, maybe a type, but it's probably going to be set user and then it like a type thing, then marking notifications for a user viewed and, you know, as viewed in general. So yeah, I guess that's it for now. We'll actually be retrieving this data very, very soon. And we'll just print it out as well. It'll be in a very simple format, but it will be printed. So that's it for part 45 in this creating a PHP web framework series. If you like the video, please give it a thumbs up, hit that subscribe button, and leave us a comment. If you want to contribute, feel free to commit code to GitHub, add suggestions for Trello, the wiki, or any ideas in general. If you have any questions, feel free to post them on our educational platform, sonarlearning.co.uk. There'll be a link in the description as usual. There'll be a GitHub link as well. Feel free to contact us via Facebook, Twitter, Google+, Reddit, however else you see fit. And as usual, thank you for watching, and I will see you in day 46.